Hello everyone, and thanks for watching CSE Academy. This is Abhidhanama Siddhepai, and now we are continuing with the computer science for O levels. And the students who can benefit from this course, they can be IGCSE-0478 and GCSE-2210. Now we are continuing with the lecture contents. The first topic is data representation. Here the objectives include binary data representation, binary or decimal, octal, and hexadecimal. As far as octal is concerned, basically octal has no value or use in GCSE or in the syllabus, but for the reference to show you the part that how octal can deal or can be dealt using number systems in a go through. So now continuing with the objectives, first one is the binary. We have several conversions here: decimal to binary, binary to decimal, binary to hexadecimal, binary or decimal to hexadecimal, hexadecimal to binary, and hexadecimal to decimal. Now we have the last one is the octal methods that can be incorporated as per the need required. Now next is the number systems with digit range. What we need to know here, basically the type of the number system, the digit range, and the base it has, or base is also known as radix. As far as the binary number system is concerned, basically it has just two digits, that is 0 and 1. You can see, and the representation of the two digits you can see in the base block, that is, you can see it's 10110, or it is read from right to left. First of all, you have to remember this thing, that the number, binary number, will be read from right to left. So 01101, and then you can come to the decimal or binary, where only 10 digits are there. You have 10 combinations of digits, that is 0 to 9, and the base, you can see the example with the base 27 within parentheses, and 10 is the subscripted value, which represents that the base or the number system you are dealing with is base 10 decimal. Now the third one is the octal, which has 8 digits right from 0 to 7, and the last, the biggest digit, the maximum digit or maximum number in octal is 7. You can see that the base is represented by 8. Coming to the fourth one, that is hexadecimal. Now it has two different categories, and it is, or you can say that it is divided into two categories. The first one is numbers from 0 to 9, and the second one is hexacharacters or hexadecimal, A to F, which range from A equals to 10, B equals to 11, C equals to 12, and D equals to 13, E equals to 14, and F equals to 15. So now this way you can understand that these all things are related to decimal systems, hexa, binary, decimal, octal, hexadecimal. All these systems are used to represent in binary. We have other systems, so we have to focus only on these number systems: binary, decimal, octal, and hexadecimal. Now moving on to the other one, that is decimal to binary conversion. This is the decimal to binary conversion. Now here you can see this. Let's suppose here we have the understanding that how to understand memory table binary registers. So this is the very first beginning of this. Here you can manage this by understanding the value, the powers, and the values which will be generated by raising the power of 2. Now this binary register is represented in a table format. You can see here as location and value. Now if the power p is raised to the power p, p is the power of 2, where you can understand this easily, that how this works. Simply you can just keep on raising the values or powers of 2, and you will get the binary machine notation table. And on the other hand, you can see that if you are just doubling the number, let's suppose 1 double is 2, 2 double is 4, 4 double is 8, and so on in binary system only. Now here you can see the location basically is the 0, 2 raised to the power 0, which will give you 1, 2 raised to the power 1 will give you 2, and so on. You can see that. Now binary digits basically represent on and off states. what you have to do is basically 0 stands for off and 1 stands for on. If the instruction is processing, that means the instruction must be on. If the instructions are off, that means the instruction must have 0 states. So this is the movement of the binary data here. Now moving on to the conversion method. Now let's suppose we have decimal to binary conversion. Here we have a decimal number which is 56. Base 10, you can see, and the empty parenthesis which required to write the binary value or binary converted value. Now here you can see that I have the block here. Symbol value, or this is already known as the symbol value, which will be put in the 8 bits block. Here you can see the 8 bit binary register. This is also known as 8 bit binary registers. And I have kept the name position values. Position values means the use value, that means under which you will put 1 to count the upper value. So this will help you calculating the decimal value equivalent to binary. Now notice that the binary number 56 base 10. Now you have to count total from the position values and mark 1 under the values you need to calculate till you get 56. Similarly, that you have to just add the values under which you have marked 1. Rest of the blocks will be filled with 0. Now coming to this block, position values, as you can see that they have been created by using 2 raised to the powers, and 2 raised to the power 0 which will give 1, 2 raised to the power 1 will give 2, 2 raised to the power 2 will give 4. Let's suppose 2 into 2 4, 2 into 3, that means 2 into 2 into 2, that means will give you 8. And hence the symbol values will be those values which will make the total of 56. Now you will be putting ones under those values, those position values, which will make a sum of 56. Now see that how this works. Let's suppose you need 56, 32. Yes, the one is done. Then how many more? Yes, 16. 32 plus 16 equals to 48. How many more? You need more, 8 more, right? Let's suppose this is the equivalency of the 56. But you need to fill in the rest of zeros, other blocks. So now keep on seeing. Now your 8 bit number is done. The 8 bit register has been completed. Now you can see that this number is formed by using 8 bits. Now the first number, the first value you got to make 56 is 64. The second one is 16 and the third one is 8. Now this number appears there, and the value which was required in binary equivalent was 0001100. Now this way you have got the number equivalent to binary. Now see how do we do it, the verification. Let's suppose 32, then plus 16, then you have to add 8, so this becomes 56. Now in the same way you have to just verify that which value you have copied here and which values you have copied here. You have 3 values under which you have put ones, and now you can see ultimately the result, that is 0001100 in 8 bits register. Now this is done. This is 32, this is 16, and this is the 8. Now here you have completed the number. The question, if the number of conversion you have this by using binary registers, you will convert from decimal to binary by using this easy method. So I hope you will like this. Thanks for watching. We will discuss the next decimal to binary other conversions in the next tutorials. Thanks for watching.